How do Mendel's experiments show that the traits may be dominant or recessive, traits inherited independently? Mendel, he is known as father of genetics, and he chose pea plants for his experiment. Okay, so Mendel actually crossed purebred tall pea plants with purebred dwarf pea plants, and he found that only tall pea plants were produced in the F1 generation. So he actually took one pair of contrasting character within two plants. Okay, so this cross is known as monohybrid cross. So where he has taken pure tall pea plants and purebred dwarf pea plants, and he crossed these two plants. And then he found in F1 generation, that is first filial generation, okay, he has got all tall plants. Okay, so there were no dwarf pea plants. So in F1 generation, he has got all tall plants. So then he concluded that first generation that showed that traits of only one of the parent plant, that is tallness. So the trait of the other parent plant, that is dwarfness, did not show up in the progeny of the first generation. So that is what, if you see in this F1 generation, all the plants are tall. There are no dwarf plants at all. Okay. So it means in this generation, the traits of only one of the parent plant, that is tallness, and the trait of the other parent plant, dwarfness, that did not show up in this progeny. Okay, yeah. So then he crossed these tall pea plants which were obtained in the F1 generation. So he has taken these tall plants which are obtained in the F1 generation. Okay, so then he found that both tall and dwarf plants were obtained in the second generation, that is in F2 generation. So second filial generation. So when he crossed these F1 plants, he has got both tall and dwarf plants. Okay. And that is in the ratio of 3:1. So these are three tall plants and this is short plant. So he noted that dwarf trait of the parent pea plant, which disappeared in the first generation. So we didn't see any dwarf pea plants in the first generation, right? Yeah. But it has reappeared in the second generation. But we have seen the dwarf character, dwarf pea plant in the F2 generation. So, in this way, Mendel's experiment with tall and dwarf pea plant showed that traits may be dominant and recessive. Okay, yeah. So, then he concluded that the one which shows its expression in the presence of contrasting character, that is what known as dominant, and the other which is suppressed by the dominant character is known as recessive. So in this way, he showed that the traits may be dominant and recessive. Let's see the second question, traits inherited independently. So for this experiment, actually he conducted a dihybrid cross. So just now we have discussed what is monohybrid cross. So it is a cross between two plants with one pair of contrasting character. So the dihybrid cross means it is with two pair of